So I finally gave in. I finally purchased some lighting equipment with the hopes of starting to record more videos about some of the things that I'm doing in my classroom. It's been a while since I've vlogged, and frankly, it's just been a really crazy year. I've been trying so many different things with my students, and I thought that since this is such a big journey and such a different kind of experience that I've had in the past with teaching, I thought I really need to spend some time documenting some of my struggles because I think that that would really help some of the other teachers that pay attention to my vlog and look at my Instagram and YouTube channel. So I finally broke down and I purchased some lighting equipment. And again, my hope was just to basically be able to help other teachers that are really struggling. So just to remind you a little bit about my story, for about, I would say about 6 years, I was a chalk and talk teacher. And you know, while there's nothing wrong with that, science lends itself to be able to be so interactive. And so I found that I really wasn't the teacher that I wanted to be. So I went on this journey of trying to basically become the science teacher that I knew that I could be, but I just needed some guidance and I needed some help. And so I did the best that I could when I first started teaching. You know, I tried to look for more interactive ways, but you know, at the school that I was teaching at, everyone was pretty much a chalk and talk teacher, and it was viewed as you not playing nice in the sandbox, I guess, if you will, if you were to be doing something so different. So, long story short, and a couple of different jobs later, I finally landed one of my dream jobs. You know, nothing's ever perfect. You know, I still don't have my own classroom, and you know, I'm essentially a cart teacher. But I am the teacher that I've wanted to be, and it's taken a lot of time. And it's been a struggle because students don't often realize what's best for them. And so you have to kind of plead your case on a regular basis and you have to be consistent. And so here I am today, and I'm happy to say that I'm really enjoying finally kind of feeling more comfortable with this more student-centered learning. There's still so much for me to learn, but I think that through the help of my colleagues, through the help of my supervisor, I really feel so empowered to teach students chemistry, but not only teach them the skill of how to learn something difficult. And that's really at the heart of what I do every day. I mean, I don't care if my students can write a formula or they can perform stoichiometry calculations. Of course, that's really nice, but I know at the end of the day, my mission as a teacher isn't necessarily to just teach chemistry, it's really to teach the students how to learn something difficult like chemistry. So it's teaching them the skills of, you know, hey, when they're in that college class and maybe they're studying calculus, you know, what to do in order to understand the content. So at the end of the day, that's really what I hope to do. And I think by me sharing my experiences with you, that will allow you to kind of have a more of appreciation. You know, again, it's going to be a struggle. Your students are not always going to understand why you're doing what you're doing. And, you know, often I'll get the complaint, you're not teaching us. You know, and it's really sad because those are the students that won't appreciate until later on what you're doing. And my hope is many years down the road, when they're struggling in a class, they'll think back to that chemistry class and they'll remember what it was like to struggle and they'll remember what they had to do in order to be successful. And so that's really at the heart of what I'm trying to do with my YouTube channel now. And so with that said, I'm going to leave you, but look forward to more videos. I can't wait to start posting.